Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, The Binary World, and today I'm going to talk on competitive programming and everything that a beginner must know before starting competitive programming. So let's get started. Before that, let me introduce myself. I am Shankar from NIT DGP. I'm in second year currently. And I'm at expert level in code forces, you can see. And for some personal reasons, I have just blurred out my code forces handle. So let's see. First, let us see what is competitive programming. It is actually a mind sports in which you are given some questions and you need to solve them in given amount of time. Questions are mostly logical or mathematical or algorithmic. These three kinds of questions you are going to find in competitive programming. Based on your problem solving abilities, you are awarded ratings, just same as what happens in PUBG. So why is it so beneficial? Most companies in their interview rounds, they are going to ask you questions on data structures and algorithms in their first round. So if you are good at CP, it is going to be very easy for you. CP is going to help you in these interviews. Also, if you are from not a very good college like IITs or NITs, then you can apply for off-campus jobs, and in these jobs there you have to appear for tests which are going to be based on data structures and algorithms, and you can grab really big offers. I know some people who have grabbed very, very big offers, bigger than the offers that you see in IITs. They are from just tier 3 colleges and they have done it. Very big offers, you can grab it. Also, there are many other benefits of CP which are not very direct. These are indirect benefits, and in the long term they are going to help you. It actually increases your thinking ability, it boosts your confidence, and there are a lot more benefits. But the benefit that beginners get attracted to mainly is that the interviews, that is what matters mostly to the beginners. So let's get started with CP and see how you can start with CP. First step is to learn a programming language. This is the most important step. So if you don't have any idea about any programming language during your school life, if you did not learn any language, so if you are totally new in this field, you can start with a language like C++. I would prefer C++ because of its STL. So once you are done with learning a programming language, you don't need to learn it in very depth, like you don't need to learn the object oriented programming and all those stuff. You need to know the basics, just input output sortings and C++ STL. That's all you're going to need for competitive programming. So the next step, once you're done with step one, the next step is going to be learn some basic mathematics. Of course, we are taught these topics like GP, AP and permutation and combination in our plus two level, but and some geometry as well. But I have seen many are not good at these topics. So it will be better if you revise these topics. You don't need to solve very hard problems, but you just need to know the formulas and NCR, these things, NCR, NPR, and binomial coefficients, all these things you need to know. And there is one more important topic, this is number theory. This topic we are not taught in schools in India. This is a very bad thing that we are not taught, but for CP you are going to need this. So you can use the YouTube resources to get an idea about this topic. Also, there are very good websites which I am going to mention later on in my video. Once you are done with the first two steps, come to the third step, that is create an account in online platforms like Codeforces or CodeChef. There are other platforms as well like HackerRank and HackerEarth, but I don't prefer those because the level of questions are good, but you are going to find a lot of problems in the question. Like there are mistakes in the questions, or sometimes there is a lot of ambiguity. So the best platform I would say is Codeforces. The questions are very good. Also, a very good thing about Codeforces is that the questions are graded according to their difficulty. You can find the rating for the questions. The ratings start from 800 to about 3000. So each question is given a rating, and the more the rating, the harder the question is. So you can choose the questions for yourself. Also, ABCD questions are given. ABCD, A question is the easiest one, then B is a little bit harder than that, and C is harder than B, and so on. So create an account, and after that try participating in contests or choose some A problems which are the easiest one that comes in contests, and try solving these A problems. Mostly these are easy questions. I hope you will be able to solve it, but still, if you can't solve it, go and check out the editorials. After every contest, you are going to find a link at the bottom to the editorial where the solutions are given, and it's explained in details how you can approach the problem. Also, if you can't understand from the editorials, then there are some very good YouTube channels which make editorials on Codeforces questions, and I'll give a link to these channels. The most important thing, this is the most important thing, keep trying until you succeed, because there will be a lot of time when you are going to fail. Like you will be not able to do the A question as well, so you have to spend hours with a particular problem. At the beginning you will be frustrated, but if you leave it, 99% people live in this step. They try for 2-3 days and they feel like I'm not getting anything, so let's just leave. But that's not the way. If you want to succeed at CP, or if you want to become really good at data structures and algorithms, you are going to fail, and you have to keep trying. That's the ultimate secret. Next thing, that is, you have to be consistent. You can't do a problem today and the next one you are doing at after 1 month or 2 months. That's not going to help, because whatever you learn today, you are going to forget everything after 1 month. So consistency is the key. You have to solve one problem at least every day. Also, take part in contests regularly, even if your ratings are dropping every day. I have seen many people who tell that I don't want to take part in contest because my ratings are dropping every day. But ratings are not going to be of any help if you are not good at the main thing, that is programming. So ratings are just a number, and you have to keep trying. Yeah, so now I'll tell you some important resources that you can use to master competitive programming. In JE preparation, during the JE preparation, we had a lot of books like DC Pandey, HC Verma, but in CP, there are not many good books. This is the hard fact, because the community is much smaller in size. So you have to rely on YouTube channels. there are some great YouTube channels by some of the best coders. Tushar Roy is one of them. This is a very good YouTube channel. He explains the classical problems. Also, Code and Code. He has covered every topic from the beginning to the end. It's a complete course on CP. And if you want the editorials, you can watch this guy's video. He makes videos on Codeforces problems. Also, there are some other channels like Eric To. This is the spelling, I think. Eric To. He's a he has a channel. He makes videos on Codeforces editorials. Also, you have got a lot of online resources which you need to use wisely. This is Geeks for Geeks, CP Algorithms. These two are mainly the best resources. Also, there is one Stack Overflow. So, when you are having a doubt in a particular algorithm, you can just check out this Geeks for Geeks or Stack Overflow. These two things are going to help you a lot. Coming to the next thing, that is what are the topics in CP. So the topic that you should start with is, I think, in my opinion, it's mathematics. You should learn the basic formulas like AP formulas, GP formulas, and a little bit of the series and how these things work. Then you must go for sortings. You should learn how sort works. Like, start with bubble sort, then try insertion sort, and then go for the advanced sorting techniques like merge sort or quick sort. Then go for binary search. These are the basic things that you must learn before getting into CP. And the next thing is recursion. This is a underrated topic, but I have seen this is of much use in CP. If you know recursion, you are going to solve a lot. You are going to be able to solve a lot of problems. So I would suggest you to do 50 problems at least on recursion. Then learn some implementation based problems. Then try out some implementation problems on Codeforces. You can give the problem filters. Like in Codeforces, you have the facility to give the topic and choose what problems you want to solve. You can solve on that particular topic that you wish. So once you're done with implementation problems, go for simulation problems and ad hoc problems. These problems are generally the easy ones. You don't need to think much about these problems. It just increases your implementation abilities. Like what you are thinking, you have to convert your thoughts into code. So these problems are going to help you in converting your thoughts to code. Then learn some data structures, like the basic ones: stacks, queues, lists, arrays, and these are all the basic ones. And once you are done with that, go for greedy algorithms and number theory. These two topics, if you know well, you are going to solve A and B problems in Codeforces in every contest, and that is going to give you a lot of confidence. Next, when you are done with greedy algorithms, you have to go for some little bit more advanced things like graph theory, game theory, dynamic programming, bit manipulation, and combinatorics. So for DP or dynamic programming, I would suggest that you should for DP your recursion should be very good. And for DP, I would suggest that first you should solve some classical DP problems, and once you are done with those, you can go for Codeforces problems. And if you want me to make a video on each of these topics, you can let me know in the comment section. So I'll make a video on how you can approach each of these things. things. Then these two things are not asked in interviews. These are only for CP. If you are into CP, if you are loving to solve problems, then you can go for these two things, that is segment trees and Fenwick trees. And when you are done with this, you can start with Mohs algorithm, square root decomposition, centroid decomposition, heavy light decomposition. So these are very advanced topics, you don't need at this moment, but if you want, you can go for them. But till graph theory, game theory, DP, bit manipulation, these are must, because all these are asked in interviews of the productist companies. So please like, share and subscribe. And if you want more videos on CP or any specific topic of CP that you want to know, and how to approach that topic, or what are the resources on that particular topic, you can let me know in the comment section below. Also, if you have got any doubt regarding anything related to CP, you can comment it below. So bye.